Now, we'll keep you up to date on that game. Everybody out to the East region now, up in Syracuse, where Penn and UMass are about to tip it off. Mel Proctor and Dan Bonner are at courtside, and Mel, you're on.
Welcome to first round action at the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York, as the 14-seeded Penn Quakers meet the 3rd-seeded UMass Minutemen. In action you'll see this afternoon from the Carrier Dome, Virginia and Manhattan, a matchup of 6 and 11. Tonight, New Mexico State and Nebraska, 7 against 10. And in the finale, the second-seeded team in the East, the Cincinnati Bearcats, will meet Coppin State, seeded 15. Hello, everybody. I'm Mel Proctor along with Dan Bonner. Dan, we've already had one major upset in the tournament out west last night. Santa Clara, seeded 15th, upended the second-seeded Arizona team. Is there the possibility of an upset today in our first game with 3 against 14?
Now, there's always the possibility, and that's what folks hope for in the tournament, particularly if you're fans of the lower-seeded team. For the third-seeded Massachusetts Minutemen, they realize that in every tournament since 1985, a third seed has been knocked off, and all the other third seeds have won, and John Calipari has been clipping all the articles that are written that says that this is the best shot for a 14 seed to upset a third seed. So third-seeded Massachusetts knows they have their hands full today.
And there are a lot of people who think that Penn is better than a 14th seed, and they have an outstanding backcourt led by Matt Maloney and Jerome Allen.
The strength of the Penn Quakers lies in their backcourt. Sophomore Matt Maloney, excellent three-point shooter, averages about 16 points a game, handles the ball very well. He's going to be tough for UMass to contain. His running mate in the backcourt, another sophomore, the Ivy League Player of the Year, Jerome Allen, at about 6'4", very athletic. Penn is based on the perimeter, and UMass is concerned about how they're going to handle those guys.
Well, while Penn will fire away from the outside, their strength in their backcourt, UMass will pound the ball inside of their two big guys, Lou Rowe and Harper Williams.
It's one of those classic inside-outside matchups. University of Massachusetts is not tall in terms of height, but in Harper Williams, who you see right here, and Lou Rowe, they're very strong inside. Williams, an excellent player down on the block. Lou Rowe, a tremendous rebounder, particularly a very fine offensive rebounder. Penn is going to be hard-pressed to take care of those guys, and I guess whoever's able to go to their strengths the best is going to be in great shape in this game.
All right, Dan, on the starting lineups today, Eric Moore, Barry Pierce, and Sean Trice across the front line with Maloney and Allen in the backcourt for Penn. And for UMass, Lou Rowe, Harper Williams, the freshman Dana Dingle, with Derek Kellogg and Tony Barbee at the guards. And the officials for today's game, Stan Reynolds, Brian Stout, and Dave Baer. UMass representing the Atlantic 10 Conference. They were regular season and postseason champions. They bring a 23-6 record into today's game. Penn 22-4. They were the Ivy League champions, breathing through the ivy with a 14-0 record. Fran Dunphy in his fourth year as the head coach of the Penn Quakers, a former guard at LaSalle. He played under Tom Golan in the late 60s, early 70s. Ready to go from the Carrier Dome. UMass in white, Penn in the dark blue uniforms. Eric Moore against Lou Rowe, and UMass will have first possession. This is Derek Kellogg, the steady point guard. Three is Dana Dingle.
Man-to-man defense by the Penn Quakers to start. They're basically a man-to-man team.
Dingle on the drive. And Jerome Allen, the guard, grabbing the first rebound for Penn. Penn will run if they have the opportunity. Matt Maloney wastes no time connecting from long range. That was a two-point shot.
That gives you a perfect idea of how quick he is shooting the basketball. You've got to stay on him. Penn now drops into a zone.
And an aggressive zone.
Going to try to give Massachusetts some different looks. UMass, remember, not particularly strong from the outside when Jerome Malloy is not in the basketball game. They have to try to cut off the inside game.
UMass showing good patience, not forcing anything. Penn leading 2-0. Shot clock is down to 11 seconds, so the Minutemen have to start looking for a shot. Kellogg penetrates and takes the jumper. And a rebound by Eric Moore of Penn, and Kellogg commits a foul.
Now UMass did not look very comfortable against that zone defense. J. John Calipari knows that his team has to get the ball inside to be successful, and I think we can expect to see his left-handed sharpshooter, Jerome Maloney, in the ballgame very quickly if Penn stays with that zone.
Kellogg puts pressure on Matt Maloney, who brings it across. Sean Trice throws it back out to Allen. Trice maneuvering inside, but his shot was blocked by Harper Williams.
Lots of times, Mel, you will see teams drop down from the guard position to help the big guys inside. I think what you'll see from UMass today is the big guys.
Oh, beautiful play. Allen into Barry Pierce. And it's 4-0 Penn. This is what John Calipari was worried about, Penn getting off to a good start. And a foul committed by Sean Trice of Penn.
Penn is very pleased with the seeding that they have. UMass is not a real big team inside, and Penn feels like they can match up. And you're right, Mel, the longer they stay close in the basketball game, the more confidence that they get, the tougher they become.
Penn back in his own defense. 22 is Tony Barbee, perhaps UMass' best all-around player. He can do a little bit of everything. Dingle to find freshman number 3. Barbee puts up a three-pointer. And Penn is doing an excellent job screening off on the boards. UMass hasn't been able to get any offensive rebounds so far. It's 4-0 Penn. Maloney inside the three-pointer. And the long rebound is grabbed by Lou Rowe. Barbee goes inside to Williams. And it's 4-2 Penn with 17:38 remaining in the first half from Syracuse.
Williams, a strong left-handed player down on the block.
Pierce nails the jump shot, but Penn surely is showing no signs of nervousness in this first round game. They are coming out firing. Shooting very well in the early going.
The number 14 seed, Mel, what do you have to lose? And they're out here playing with confidence, and they are loose.
They've hit 3 of their first 5 shots.
They're trying to match up out of that zone. Trying to keep track of Harper Williams.
Barbee on the pull-up. And a foul underneath against Penn. Looks like it's on Sean Trice.
Trice picks up the foul. We talked about how difficult it would be to keep Lou Rowe off the offensive board. He showed you right there. He's all over it.
Andy Barada checks in for Penn. And a substitution for UMass, Jerome Maloney, an excellent outside shooter, good three-point shooter, checks in. They hope maybe he can hit some jump shots against his zone.
Trice had those 2 personal fouls, so he had to go out of the ball game.
6-2 Penn, 16:45 remaining, first half. They pick up Maloney quickly. He's an excellent shooter. Barbee is their jam. Tony Barbee averaging 13.5 points a game, cuts Penn's lead to 2.
Good reaction to the traps.
Jerome Allen goes one-on-one and puts it up. Penn pounding the offensive boards, but finally, Harper Williams comes down with a rebound. Good ball movement by UMass, and Lou Rowe scores to tie it up.
UMass has all its points basically from point-blank range. That's where they'd like to go with the basketball. Penn's got to cut that off.
A 6 all tie in the early going here in Syracuse. Maloney looking for screens to get himself open. And a shot off the side of the board by Andy Barada.
That plays the way UMass wants it to. Those inside guys taking the perimeter shot.
And a pushing foul is called against Derek Moore of Penn.
That's his first personal foul. Harper Williams is just a lot to handle inside.
And we get a timeout on the floor here in Syracuse with 15:33 remaining. It's 6 all.
I was thinking about buying a Honda Accord, and then I saw the Oldsmobile Achieva beat the Honda Accord and Toyota Camry in a 100,000-mile test. I really believe the quality is there, and so does my husband, or we wouldn't have bought the Achieva. I've already given the 800 number to an acquaintance. If you're really thinking about getting a car, get the test results and look at the video.
For the complete results of this independent real-world test, call 1-800-THE-TEST. It's your call. Chuck Daly for Sharp.
In basketball or business, you got to know what your players can do for you.
That's why Sharp has a winning game plan for copiers. This booklet will help you find the right copier to increase productivity and reduce operating expenses. Whether you get a new Sharp high-volume copier system or a compact copier that lets you add on as your office needs grow. So call 1-800-BE-SHARP now and get your winning game plan. Because Sharp's got the players you need to win.
Whoa, Domino's is cooking! Because now every time you call us, we're giving you
something for nothing. It's really something. Really something when you call Domino's.
Now buy our new large bacon cheddar cheeseburger pizza with ground beef, bacon, mozzarella, and cheddar cheeses at regular price.
And you get a medium one-topping pizza free.
Brazil's nada for free. Tell them what our guaranteed 30-minute delivery costs them. Nothing.
Something for nothing when you call Domino's.
Just a hoot and a holler from Nashville's Grand Ole Opry is another place that's home to musicians from all over the world. It's Groon Guitars, where they sell rare and vintage instruments to everyone from Johnny Cash to Motley Crue. So if you go, remember, bring your pick and your Visa card. Because at Groon, you can take your licks on a 1939 Martin, but you can't take it home with American Express.
Yeah.
Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
A senseless murder one man vowed to solve.
You still think I did it?
Yeah, I sure do.
Robert Conrad in a psychological thriller, Sworn to Vengeance, Tuesday.
Mel Proctor with Dan Bonner back in Syracuse. And Dan, we said it would be Penn's outside game against the inside strength of UMass, and that's exactly what it's been so far.
Harper Williams is really working hard down inside. He's got a basket in the game already. He just drew a foul. Penn has 2 points. Other than the perimeter, 4 points on the perimeter, UMass has all theirs right down next to the basket.
Good passing by UMass. They get it into Rowe, who stuffs it home to give the Minutemen the lead, 8-6.
They've got one layup, two dunks, and a 2-foot turnaround jump shot. UMass getting the ball right next to the basket. UMass stays with the man-to-man defense.
Matt Maloney guarded by Chris Robinson is in the game now for UMass. Allen picked up by Dingle. And Moore way out. And a foul against Penn as Andy Barada went over the back of one of the UMass players.
UMass doing a great job passing the ball. Here they get out of trap. Look, there's four guys around the guy with the ball. Williams has basically a two-on-one. The quick pass to Rowe. And Rowe, what strength inside for the dunk.
8-6, UMass.
Penn now goes back to the man-to-man.
They've used both man-to-man and zone so far. Malloy's had a hard time getting off his jump shot. Somebody got a hand on that ball and stripped it away from Williams. Maloney trying to find the handle. Jerome Allen, the playmaker. He and Maloney team up so well in the backcourt. Maloney with a three-pointer.
That kid rises up so quickly to shoot the ball, you can't believe that he does it. Got to get closer to him than that.
And Penn regains the lead. Matt Maloney has scored 5 of the Quakers' first 9 points. Maloney, his jumper is short. And the foul is on the foul. It's just out of bounds to UMass. Substitution for the Minutemen.
That's Kellogg coming back in the basketball game. Robinson, who was in the game, he's leaving. That's right there. Robinson, number 12. What he does is just get a few minutes to rest Kellogg. Kellogg, a key cog handling the ball for UMass.
Williams powers his way in, no basket. That's a charging foul on Harper Williams.
We talked about Harper Williams working hard inside. That was an excellent job by Moore to move his feet. Williams working for the basketball. That's Barada. And then you can see Williams just drops that shoulder, goes right into him. Barada does a great job to flop on the ground, get the call.
UMass applying the full court pressure. The Quakers bring it across. They lead 9-8 with 14 minutes remaining in the first half. Maloney guarded by Kellogg.
UMass has done a great job keeping the ball out of the hands of Allen in scoring position.
Maloney with a nice move forced the shot and bricked it up there.
Good defense.
Kellogg pushes it into the front court wearing those dark socks that so many players are wearing. Looks like he's wearing his street socks. Maloney misses the three-pointer. He has yet to find the range. Oh, look out. Barada had his back turned and didn't see the pass, but the Quakers get it back. Barry Pierce up with a loose ball.
Don't want to be running through the lane not looking for the ball.
Maloney for three, and he's got it going. Matt Maloney, averaging 16 and a half points a game, has eight already, and Penn leads 12-8.
A couple of times this season, Maloney made 8 3-point baskets in a game, so he's very capable. John Calipari just waving his arms over there.
Kellogg misses a three, and the long rebound to Maloney. Good passing. Jerome Allen takes it inside and gets it blocked by Harper Williams. 12-8 Penn. Dana Dingle into the lane, and he draws the foul. Foul is called on Eric Moore of Penn. That's his second. Tony Barbee is back in. Mike Williams, who's missed the last six games with a broken hand, is also in the game for UMass. You can see his right hand is heavily taped.
You know, it's very funny, interesting, I guess, that University of Massachusetts, three different players this year suffered exactly that same injury.
I guess they lead the NCAA in broken hands.
Broken right.
Hands down. And a foul against Penn. Jeff Meyer and Harper Williams, the other two players, who also suffered broken hands in addition to Mike Williams.
You know what John Calipari is telling Derek Kellogg? He's telling him he's got to get up and guard Matt Maloney.
The foul is on Andy Barada of Penn. The Quakers have 16 fouls, UMass with two. This is Dana Dingle, a freshman from the Bronx. He was an All-Atlantic 10 All-Freshman selection this year.
Brought along slowly by John Calipari, but really stepped in and did a great job when Williams went out with the injury.
12-9 Penn, 12 and a half remaining in the first half from the Carrier Dome. The winner of this game meets the winner of the Virginia Manhattan game coming up.
Tim Krug in the ballgame, number 23 for Penn.
Pierce into the lane. Good head fake by Krug to free himself, and he hits his first shot.
Krug, for a big guy, has nice range out to 15 feet, and he's very aggressive with the basketball.
Krug, just a freshman on a very young team. There are no seniors on his Penn team.
Back to the zone for Penn.
14-9 Penn. 12 minutes remaining in the first half.
What you'd like to do is get the ball inside against the zone, and then if the zone collapses, get it back outside for the open jumper.
Barbee's jumper off the mark. Rebounded by Pierce. Barry Pierce, an excellent rebounder, only 6'3", but jumps well. Can also handle the ball. Sometimes. UMass in a man-to-man as Maloney backs it out. He likes to work off the screens. 22 is Scott Kegler, who's in the game for Penn now.
UMass does a great job with interior defense. Lou Rowe really working hard against Barada. That's a very interesting off-the-ball battle.
Shot clock is down to 8 seconds. Penn's got to start looking for a shot. They're not even close. Pierce puts up a three-pointer that rims out. Barbee comes away with a loose ball. Penn leading 14-9. Barbee open for three. A rebound to Pierce. Looked like Kellogg may have gotten a hand on it. Either that or Pierce just lost it, but he had a clear shot to the basket. Mike Williams. Barbee with the offensive rebound. Pierce having a problem dribbling that ball. That was right after I said he was a good ball handler, too. Rebounded by Lou Rowe. Penn has had several fairly easy opportunities in transition and hasn't been able to score.
There's an awful lot of up and down activity in this game. I don't know that either team wants to play as fast as they have been playing. John Calipari telling his troops to slow it down a little bit.
Barbee on the drive. Good help defensively by Barada to shut him off. Dingle. UMass has suddenly gone cold.
UMass doing a lot of standing around on offense. Boy, Kellogg, very active, Kellogg, very active against the ball.
Pierce for three. Very Pierce shooting 36% from three-point range gives Penn a 17-9 lead with 9:43 remaining in the half.
UMass looks like they're having a hard time deciding who's guarding whom. And as a result, Penn is getting some open shots in the transition.
Penn back in the 2-3 zone again. Barbie is shut off. Out to Kellogg.
Kellogg can shoot it, but does not shoot the ball very much. Mike Williams is an excellent three-point shooter, but he's very streaky.
Shot clock winding down the Minutemen. Eight on the shot clock as they pound it inside to Rowe. Out of bounds to Penn. And we'll return to Syracuse, where Penn leads UMass by eight.
Cellular One has set up state-of-the-art cellular service that reaches clear across America. Beautiful, isn't it?
The best defense is not to offend. Thus, introducing the new Right Guard Sports Stick. Now with a time-release formula for longer-lasting protection against hostile odor all day. For protection that endures.
There is a sound you'll hear in the triangle below Canal Street. It's the sound of German being spoken by those who are moved by the art. In your town, America, and the world, Beck's, the number one imported German beer.
Five generations ago, our ancestors had dreams for us. They turned their dreams into our reality through hard work, devotion, and a revolutionary idea of their day, mutual life insurance. Introduced to America in 1843 by Mutual of New York, over the past 150 years, we've helped turn millions of dreams into reality. And we'll continue for as long as people continue to dream. Mutual of New York, money for life.
Isn't it amazing how quick and agile these big guys are? You should test drive the 88 LSS by Oldsmobile. It's very agile. But don't take our word for it. Take Car and Driver's. The 88 luxury sedan, only from Oldsmobile. It's like grace under pressure. It's your money.
If your spouse was accused of poisoning your child...
I didn't kill my baby.
Would you believe she was innocent?
I never stopped loving you.
Lisa Hartman Black, Without a Kiss Goodbye, Sunday.
A beautiful day in Syracuse, New York, if you're a Penguin. They had 48 inches of snow here over the weekend. You can still see the remnants of it. Probably a lot of people still trying to find their cars. The roof of the Carrier Dome was actually covered with snow. They had to deflate the roof. Drained the snow off. They melted the snow with hot water hoses and hot air and shoveled some of it over the sides and then got the water down the floor of the Carrier Dome. The basketball floor was not down at the time. Drained all the water off and somehow got this building ready for this tournament. They've done a marvelous job. I know Dan Bonner was up on the roof helping the workers the other day. Dan, how was that experience?
It was like a roller coaster without a seat.
We're only kidding. Dan did volunteer, but they wouldn't allow him to go up on the roof. He was too tall. Harper Williams is fouled as he works inside.
Harper Williams trying to operate on the inside, and as you can see, that's where UMass has had most of their success. We talked about Penn being a perimeter team. That graphic right there completely illustrates what we're talking about. Penn getting it down on the perimeter. UMass not shooting the ball very well at all, only 4 of 17. They've missed some opportunities inside, but Penn has defensed the inside very well.
Foul is on Tim Krug. This is Harper Williams, averaging 16 a game to lead the team. He was the Atlantic 10 Player of the Year last year. This year, Aaron McKee of Temple won that award, although Williams was again selected first-team All-Conference and made the All-Tourney team. In fact, he was the MVP of the A-10 Tourney.
UMass now going to trap. They try to double-team and then drop back very quickly into a man-to-man. UMass really looks tight to me, Mel, and maybe this pressure will help get them back on track.
Definite difference in the demeanor of these two teams. Penn is playing free and easy, and UMass looks a little nervous, to be honest with you. good shot. And it's out. Ooh, that was off a UMass player.
It's ruled that went off Kegler.
So really, the UMass ball.
Really fun to watch Harper Williams play inside for the University of Massachusetts. He works very, very hard.
UMass has Kellogg, Barbie, Malloy, Williams, and Mike Williams on the floor. Harper and Mike Williams both in there. Rowe is out. This is Mike Williams. A wild shot, missed it. Harper Williams can't follow.
Good defense inside by Penn. Harper Williams had the rebound but couldn't put it back in. UMass thus far doing a pretty good job against the high screens that Penn likes to set to get their perimeter guys open.
Penn has Kegler, Krug, Moore, Jerome Allen, and Maloney on the floor. And the foul is called on Harper Williams. That's his second. And we'll be back.
The NCAA Women's Final Four, April 3rd on CBS.
Obviously, there is a new style. Definitely a new priority. Most importantly, an improvement in the economy. And without a doubt, a changing of the guard.
Too many businesses today leave their customers up in the air. But Allstate is different. Your Allstate agent's job is to keep you secure for years to come. To stick by you so that you stay with Allstate for your car insurance and home insurance. For years. For life. You're in good hands with Allstate.
There are two ways to put a movie theater in your home. You could build one. Or you could simply buy the giant 35-inch RCA home theater with SRS sound. It's the easiest way to get a movie theater in your home. Now, get up to $100 back on selected RCA home theater televisions.
Blue. Got to thinking about his career. Said I can do more than just blue blazers. I'm getting a new agent. So he signed with Dockers. And from storm blue to sapphire, indigo to cobalt, we took blue to heights he never dreamed. Now blue's a star. But he's never forgotten who gave him his big break. Dockers. Nobody does blue like Dockers.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
Catchy little tune there. Pat O'Brien along with Mike Francesa in New York. Coming up at halftime, we're going to get you up to date and get you out to some of the other active games going on. Mike, what's going on around the country right now?
Well, Oklahoma State, Marquette, you figured a defensive struggle here, Pat. Neither team shooting the ball very well. Neither team finished the season very strongly. Bryant Reeves, the big guy inside, the prototypical big-time, really an old-time center, big country, not in the game right now. But a guy who can be a very powerful force down the stretch as Oklahoma State is kind of taking charge.
Send everybody out to the southeast now in Nashville, where Tennessee, Chattanooga, and Wake Forest are playing. Rodney Rogers did not get a wake-up call yet.
Rodney Rogers only 2 points, and Wake very sloppy. Another team that didn't finish the season strongly, but a team that has the ability to move along in this tournament if they can find the right stride. Very inconsistent club. The Moccasins have won 18 of their last 19.
Active games going on at halftime. We'll get you out to those. Right now, back to Mel Proctor and Dan Bonner. Mel.
First round action from the Carrier Dome. Penn leading UMass 17-14 with 6:45 remaining in the first half. UMass has hit only 5 of 20 shots in this first half. They've been very cold. Great save by Allen, but he flips it into Tony Barbie of UMass.
Derek Kellogg just hit the first perimeter shot that Mass has been able to knock down in this game. Big basket. It was a three-pointer.
Can you get caught up too much in trying to pound the ball inside if that's going to be your primary approach? Barbie misses the outside shot. But they went inside early, didn't have much success. Now they're taking some perimeter shots, but You go in with the idea of jamming the ball inside, can that become an obsession to a fault?
It can become an obsession, but they took some perimeter shots early in the game, and they didn't go in the basket either. That's Barry Pierce coming in the game. Scott Kegler going out. The big problem for UMass right now is with 6 minutes and 22 seconds left in the first half, Harper Williams has two personal fouls, and he's gone to the bench.
The last foul was on Dana Dingle. Jerome Allen has yet to take any shots. He drives the lane, and that'll be a charging foul on Allen, who is the co-player of the year in the Ivy League, averaging 13 a game, but he's been more concerned with passing the ball and keeping his team in the offense rather than shooting so far.
Trice back in the basketball game. You know, Allen really hasn't had the opportunity to handle the ball that much. UMass has done a great job keeping him away from scoring position. Maloney, however, has had a good game, so at least one half of the backcourt combination really working well.
Derek Kellogg puts up a three-pointer, and a long rebound to Matt Maloney, who's the leading scorer in the game with 8 points. Off to Pierce, who now has nine. Those two have combined for 17 of Penn's points. Barbie with a nice pass into Lou Rowe. The basket counts, and a foul on Jerome Allen.
UMass has done a much better job at getting easy opportunities in the transition game. Barbie running, the defense has to come. There's three guys around Barbie. That doesn't leave too many folks to guard Lou Rowe, and he's very strong inside. Converts and has the opportunity for the three-point play.
Lou Rowe, a first-team Atlantic 10 selection, also member of the all-tournament team. Misses the three-point opportunity. It's 19-16 Penn with 5.5 remaining in the first half. Allen into Trice. Try to post up Lou Rowe, and Rowe blocks his shot. Pierce on a stop and pop. Rebounded by Kellogg. Barbie takes the wing. Nice move by Barbie on the scoop. And he cuts Penn's lead to 1-19-18.
That's two transition opportunities in succession for Massachusetts.
Looks like they're beginning to settle down a little bit.
Penn's got to be careful. They've got to have the proper guys taking the shots from the proper spots on the floor. That time they had a shot inside by Trice that was blocked. They've got to get some open shots on the perimeter as they were doing early in the basketball game. This guy we haven't heard from in a while, Maloney, and as we mentioned, Allen has yet to score.
It's been Derek Kellogg who's been denying him the ball so far. Shot clock is down to 10 seconds.
Gonna spread it out.
Allen going one-on-one around Malloy, who fouled him. And that'll send Jerome Allen to the free throw line.
John Calipari very upset with Jerome Maloney. You just simply do not want your team to commit a foul with the shot clock running out. You force them into a difficult shot. You don't want to bail them out with the foul.
Mike Williams is back in for UMass, and Jerome Allen will go to the free throw line. Allen was a kid who was heavily recruited by UMass. John Calipari was telling us that he pursued Allen as hard as any kid he's ever recruited. But Allen decided to go to Penn. He's in the Wharton School. He has a wonderful job in the summer working for Mayor Ed Rendell, the mayor of Philadelphia.
They say that Allen's job involves receiving suggestions and putting them in a paragraph or two to summarize them for the mayor. We all need somebody to summarize things for us.
And then when he's done working in the mayor's office, he goes over to Veterans Stadium and works as a security guard at night. Scott Kegler's back in for the Quakers, replacing Allen. We have 4:25 remaining in the first half. Penn leads UMass 20-18. Penn seeded 14th, UMass the third seed in the East. Mike Williams, Dana Dingle, Jerome Maloney, Harper Williams, and Lou Rowe on the floor for the Minutemen.
1-3-1 zone now for Penn. They've tried to trap out of this defense previously when they've used it in the game. Harper Williams with those two personal fouls has to be very careful.
Maloney with a baseline jumper. He hasn't really been able to get it going in this first half. Good rebound by Eric Moore of Penn.
Mel, he had the open jump shot, passed it up, took a dribble into traffic.
Maloney's jumper is short. Mike Williams pushes it up. You can see his quickness. 3.5 remaining in the first half, and a turnover by UMass. Sean Pierce, who's had a big first half. Good body control to avoid the foul. Like that Barry Pierce, who now has 11.
Every time UMass gets within a point or two, Penn is able to stretch out the lead.
4-point lead for the Quakers, just over 3 minutes remaining in the half. Quick hands of Trice knocking the ball away. Maloney goes to the floor, but Mike Williams comes away with it. And a foul is called against Penn. It's on Eric Moore.
UMass really trying to force the ball inside.
That's the third foul on Penn center Eric Moore. John Calipari visiting with Jerome Malloy.
Now he's going to visit with him a little longer as he substitutes for Malloy.
Jerome Allen is back in for Penn. Tim Krug also returns. Eric Moore leaving after picking up his third foul. Mike Williams, a sophomore from Hartford, Connecticut. That's he broke his hand in the game against West Virginia on February the 27th. It's got to bother your shooting.
Yeah, absolutely. How can you shoot the ball? Get his fingers taped together as a big pat on the hand.
And with 3:02 remaining in the first half, it's 22-19, Penn.
So there's the Accord with air automatic and ABS for 19,007.
Come on.
And then there's the Grand Am with all that for 5,000 less.
Grand Am just makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
It's affordable.
Mm-hmm.
Drives great. Sporty.
It's sporty.
Monthly payments will fit.
Mm-hmm.
We get free 24-hour roadside assistance. Besides, we like the Grand Am better anyway, right?
Let's get a salesperson.
Yeah.
Are you getting the return you'll need on your retirement savings? Perhaps the one thing worse than dying is outliving your money. Call Prudential Securities.
You said you wanted a change in this country. The new meatloaf sandwich at Burger King.
BJ TV. I love this place.
Have you ever made meatloaf like this?
Melting your mouth.
Not in my house.
Flame broiled meatloaf topped with ketchup and raw onions on a sesame seed bun.
It's delicious.
Mm-hmm. Now there's a new flame broiled meatloaf sandwich. Your way right away. And you can get the new meatloaf sandwich as part of the dinner basket at Burger King.
I love this place. And I love it even more.
Because she doesn't have to cook.
Above all else, I had to win her. But should I go here or there? Or just put my pants on backwards? Would she feel it was a cosmic roller coaster to the stars? Or just a metaphysical bus ride to Palookaville? I seized the moment.
Share the six-pack. Coors Light, the right beer now.
If there's a problem getting your 800 calls, AT&T guarantees to reroute them within 5 minutes to another phone, even if it's in your home.
Hello, Sam Salmon.
In Nome, one of the 800 reasons to choose AT&T 800 service, the best in the business.
In a first-round matchup of the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, third-seeded UMass facing Penn, and Penn leads 22-19 with 3:02 left in the half. Mel Proctor with Dan Bonner back in Syracuse. Penn leading by three. The Quakers, who are seated 14th, have led UMass for most of this first half.
Penn has gotten it done from the perimeter, led by Pearson Maloney. UMass has struggled with its shooting. Very poor shooting for UMass. When they have had success, it's been inside to Harper Williams.
Neither team shooting well in the first half. Penn at 38%, UMass at 28%. Matt Maloney's had a good first half for Penn. He has 8 points.
Nice job by Kellogg. They sort of had a clear out for Maloney. Kellogg doing a nice job getting through the screen. Maloney really likes to come off that screen and pop the jump shot.
Barry Pierce is the high man for the Quakers with 11 in the first half, but they haven't been able to get Jerome Allen on track, and Dana Dingle steals it from him. Blue Rowe puts up the shot. Oh, he didn't get the roll. He wanted that one. In a fairly ragged game, we mentioned the shooting percentages. Neither team really shooting well. Penn has had a little more success from three-point range, and Barry Pierce and Matt Maloney have been the standouts for Penn. Pierce has 11, Maloney has 8.
It's a game that has been a very intense game on both ends of the court. It doesn't look very smooth because the teams aren't shooting the ball well, but Penn really working on the defensive end. So is the University of Massachusetts, and I think that's why those shooting statistics are so low.
UMass has also made only 4 of 8 free throw attempts. Rowe makes 1 out of 2.
Getting the ball inside, however, Mel, and drawing those fouls, they've got Penn's inside guys in foul trouble. Starting center Eric Moore with 3. Starting forward Sean Trice with 2.
Penn by 2 as we hit the 2-minute mark. First half action from the Carrier Dome. Pierce. Out to Allen. Maloney picked up by Kellogg. You've got to respect his three-point range. But he can put the ball on the floor very well.
That was good defense. Barbie ran at Maloney as he was shooting the ball. So just as he shot, there was a double team.
A three-pointer would give UMass the lead. And a foul underneath is called on Sean Trice of Penn, number 52.
And that's 2 starting front court players now for Fran Dunphy's squad that have 3 personal fouls. Harper Williams working very, very hard inside.
Andy Barada will replace Trice. He and Eric Moore each with 3 fouls. Comparing notes on the bench. Harper Williams with only 4 points in the first half. He's averaging 16 a game. And UMass has been brutal at the free throw line. They're 5 for 10. On the season, they shoot 70% from the line, but only 50% today. And now less than that.
Free throws are places where you have created opportunities, but you have to take advantage of those opportunities. We saw Arizona miss a lot of free throws down the stretch in their loss yesterday.
Krug misses the shot and hustles after it. But it's out of bounds to UMass.
UMass substitution number 24 in the ballgame, Jerome
Malloy is back in for UMass. Coming up at the half, Pat O'Brien and Mike Francesa from New York with a look at some other scores elsewhere in the nation. And you'll also see some of the live action taking place at other locations in this 1993 NCAA tournament. What should be a wide open tournament. There's no dominant team this year, and I think you're going to see a lot of upsets, and we've already seen one with Santa Clara dumping Arizona last night. Penn will try to take advantage of the turnover. The Quakers lead by 2 with just over a minute remaining in the first half.
John Calipari's team still looks a little tight to me, Mel. However, they're not letting that affect their defensive effort. They're doing a great job on the defensive end of the court.
Pierce forces a shot. Rebounded by Lou Rowe with 40 seconds left, and now UMass could work for the final shot of the half.
It's a perfect example of what we were talking about. The UMass defense, they made Maloney give it up, they made Allen give it up, and then they forced Pierce into a very difficult shot. And I think John Calipari would be very relieved if he could go into the locker room with this game tied at halftime.
The all-time series tied 1 game apiece. Penn won in 1969 and 70 at the Palestra, and the 72-73 season, UMass won.
It's a nice job by Penn pressuring UMass, not letting them just hold the ball for the last shot.
6 seconds left. They've got to start looking for a shot. Barbie goes one-on-one and throws up an air ball. And it's out of bounds to UMass with 1.4 seconds remaining in the half.
It's off the hands of Barry Pierce, so UMass has an opportunity to run an inbounds play and get a quick shot. We saw Penn score very easily off an inbounds play earlier in the half.
Scott Kegler checks in for defensive purposes, replacing Allen.
Don't want Allen to pick up another foul.
Barbie gets an open shot and just missed the three-pointer that would have given UMass the lead. But at halftime, it's the 14-seeded Penn Quakers leading the 3rd-seeded UMass Minutemen 22-20. And that's the end of the first half. CBS Sports exclusive coverage of NCAA basketball will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the first round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Call Domino's Pizza, and in 30 minutes you'll be enjoying a fresh hot pizza plus something for nothing. Pontiac and your nearby Pontiac dealers, we are driving excitement. And by Energizer brand batteries, nothing outlasts the Energizer. They keep going and going and going.
What we need now is the beach.
And the brew. And the bays.
Still going. Nothing outlasts the Energizer battery. It keeps going and going.
Hey, I'm vain. Of course I'm vain. That's why I comb my hair the way I do. I stay in shape the way I do. That's why I use Power Stick.
50% more wetness and odor fighters per stroke. Power Stick by Fabergé. Power that won't let you down.
I told you I was vain.
Whoa, Domino's is cooking! Because
now every time you call us, we're giving you
something for nothing. It's really something. Really something when you call Domino's.
Now buy our new large bacon cheddar cheeseburger pizza with ground beef, bacon, mozzarella, and cheddar cheeses at regular price.
And you get a medium one-topping pizza free.
Brazil's nada for free. Tell them what our guaranteed 30-minute delivery costs them. Nothing.
Something for nothing when you call Domino's.
You have to be quick.
Nice dish down low.
You have to be smart. You need a clear head. You think we could do this on drugs? Respect yourself. Don't do drugs.
If you or someone you know needs help or information concerning drug abuse, call this toll-free number, 1-800-662-HELP. This message provided by the NCAA.
This is CBS.
You're witnessing a highly sophisticated conversation. It's between the BMW 325i and the driver. It's not based on the language of words, but of feelings. How the wheel feels to the fingertips. How the pedals feel to the foot. How the seat feels to the body. But what's truly amazing isn't that this entire conversation took place in just 2.7 seconds.
CBS Sports presents Prudential Securities at the Hash. Sponsored by Prudential Securities. The most important thing we earn is your trust.
Day two, America held captivated by the NCAA basketball tournament. Pat O'Brien along with Mike Francesa. Welcome to Prudential Securities at the Half. And what about this game? A two-point game, low-scoring game as well.
UMass has not shot the ball well late in the season at all, and the Penn matchup zone gave them all kinds of fits. They were 1-9 from three, and they're going to have to beat that zone up the floor the way they're shooting the basketball, just terribly.
Ben Franklin went to Penn. I wonder what he would have been.
Point guard, had to have the ball. An electric player.
Ben wants us to go to the Midwest region, out to Indianapolis, where Marquette and Oklahoma State are battling out. Dick Stockton and Al McGuire behind the microphones. Dick and Al, you're on.
This is big country trying to lead Oklahoma State into the second round. And Oklahoma State leading Marquette 29-23 here at the Hoosier Dome in Indianapolis. Along with Al McGuire, this is Dick Stockton. As Oklahoma State has led by as many as nine, Marquette narrowed the advantage. And Bryant Reeves, who led the conference, rebounds, field goal percentage, and scoring. The last to do it was Wilt Chamberlain of Kansas 35 years ago, leading the way for the Cowboys, and he's got 15.
A nice soft touch. His only problem, he has to work on his defense, but I like to have him on my team for two more years.
Buford, the freshman, getting it into Key. He's been a big point man for Marquette. 12 points now for Damon Key. Randy Rutherford and Brooks Thompson, the backcourt for Oklahoma State. Burley with the ball with Milton Brown and Brian Reeves. It's been a big man's game. Left-handed hook. And Brown tried to stuff it through into the hands of Buford. Marquette can narrow the five-point deficit.
Coach Ed Sutton told me they've been working on that hook. He just doesn't feel comfortable with it yet.
Great pass to Key from Lockerman. So Damon Key came in averaging 13 a game, has already exceeded that with 14 points, and it's a three-point Oklahoma State lead. Yeah. Yeah.
Every time down, they want to get it into Reeves. They want to get Marquette in foul trouble, especially Key. See the two men around him? Now they'll try to box him out, put some bodies on him.
And they did effectively. Brown missed the shot. Here is Buford for three. He's got it. And Marquette has tied the score at 30.
Oklahoma State should slow it down this time down. Concentrate and get it into big country.
Marquette has run off seven straight points here in the second half. They were down by nine at one point in the first stanza.
Keys can't cover him man to man. Now they got three men around him.
Thompson hits a three, his second of the ball game, to break the tie. Oklahoma State and Marquette in a tight game in the first round. So is Penn and UMass at Syracuse there at halftime, with Penn leading by two. Wake Forest has opened up a 7-point lead in the Southeast, with other games set to get underway in a little while. Curry, who got hot toward the end of the half, hits another.
He scored the last three baskets before the half, and that's his fourth, so he's hit four for four, his last four shots.
Curry has 10 points in the game. He is the leading scorer for Marquette. They're on defense right now. Collapse around Reeves, and Thompson misses a three. Reeves, well, he reminds me of the way George Mikan looked in the 50s, you know.
Well, he's wider than Mikan. He's not only tall, he has a big body, a wide body. There's three guys around him again.
Remember when Mikan played against all those little guys? He was 6'10 out of DePaul before they had big people. It was like this, I'm sure. He's a giant among dwarfs, and the ball is knocked away, and it's still controlled by Marquette.
Good charge. Good try that time by Thompson. He got his hand on the ball, but couldn't control it. Thompson now has hit a couple shots from outside. If they're going to win, this man right there, number 22, has to start ringing up that lights on the score.
He had struggled in the final games of the Big 8 tournament, but he had a career high of 33 against Oral Roberts, so he's had some big point games. Terry Collins, the sophomore, has checked in. And Key misses a three, and the rebound into the hands of Randy Rutherford. One.
An intense, tough to grumble and tumble game up and down the court, Mike Francesa. 33-32, a little coverage there, Marquette, Oklahoma State.
Doesn't Reeves remind you like a guy you see playing like in the 40s or the 50s? Right. Like an old, he could have been in Hoosiers. He could have been a big guy in the movies. I mean, he looks like a guy you saw 30, 40 years ago.
In the Southeast region, Mike, they're at the halftime now. Wake Forest leads 38-31. Rodney Rogers did indeed get that wake-up call. He has 14 points in the first half. We want to let everybody know what our next tier of games is going to be in this first round on this Friday in the tournament. Northeast Louisiana and Iowa, Manhattan College, Virginia, Delaware, Louisville, George Washington, and New Mexico. All of those games started between 2:45 and 3 o'clock. We'll be here all day with that. We have more coming from New York City as we head along that road to the Final Four. Stay with us here on CBS.
CBS Sports presents Prudential Securities at the Hash. Sponsored by Prudential Securities. The most important thing we earn is your trust. CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the first round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. Gillette Sensor and the new Gillette Series. Gillette, the best a man can get. And by the people of Nike, who encourage you to just do it.
It's halftime in Syracuse with Penn leading UMass 22-20. Possible upset in the making here with the 14-seeded Penn Quakers leading the third-seeded UMass Minutemen. And I'm sure you know that with Santa Clara upsetting Arizona, that all the coaches who had teams seeded 13th, 14th, 15th, and so forth used that in their pregame inspirational today.
Well, they tried to, and I'm sure John Calipari had that on his team's mind, but his team came out, I thought, very tight, Mel. They have not shot the ball well. The University of Pennsylvania has done a nice job on the defensive end of the court.
Not only have they shot poorly from the floor, they've also made just 5 of 11 free throw attempts. As we take a look at the first half stats.
Each of these teams does a real good job field goal percentage defense. You can see the field goal percentage is not very good today. On the season, that's their offensive averages, but defensively, they each hold the opponent to about 41%, so they're doing a better job than that this afternoon. The free throws, what you talked about, Mel. Massachusetts has been attacking inside. They have Penn in some foul trouble, but they haven't been capitalizing on the opportunities that they've created. There you see Barry Pierce, the leading scorer for the University of Pennsylvania, and Lou Rowe for the University of Massachusetts. You know, Lou Rowe is 3 of 4 from the field, and the rest of the team has really struggled. Talked about inside, outside. You see Penn basically on the perimeter, UMass basically on the inside. And remember, since 1985, Mel, a third seed in every tournament has been upset by a number 14 seed.
And here we go with the second half for UMass. Jerome Maloney will start the second half along with Tony Barbee and Derek Kellogg. Up front, two big guys, Harper Williams and Lou Rowe. for Penn. It'll be Matt Maloney in the backcourt. Barry Pierce, who had a big first half, also starting. Jerome Allen, Sean Trice, and Eric Moore. Both Moore and Trice have three fouls apiece. Allen has two. Maloney drills his first shot, a three-pointer. That's the way he opened the game with a long jump shot. And it's 25-20 Penn. Maloney now has 11.
Kellogg got hung up on the screen, and you just can't give Maloney any room at all. Zone defense for Penn. Watch Maloney and Allen at the top of the zone. They really try to drop down inside to cover up those big guys.
Kellogg with the open shot, two-pointer.
We talked about the University of Massachusetts emphasizing the inside game. Harper Williams, Eric Moore really going at one another. Williams struggling to get open. That's how hard that man has worked this entire basketball game.
25-22 Penn, first minute of the second half. Moore with a baseline jumper. And it's out of bounds to Penn. It was off Harper Williams.
Good battle by Trice. Remember, Sean Trice, number 52 in blue, has three personal fouls, but he didn't let that stop him. He went after Harper Williams.
Maloney, who uses those picks so well, trying to use Trice's screen. Jerome Allen was 0 for 2 from the floor in the first half and has only 1 point, but he puts it up early. They get him going, look out.
He's a much more capable player than that. The amazing thing to me is he only took two shots in the first half.
Penn by five. Maloney, who was 0 for 3 in the first half, hits his first shot. Jerome Maloney averaging 12 and a half points a game. It's Penn by three. Very young Penn team. No seniors on the team. Four sophomores and a junior. Great pass by Allen inside to Moore, and he is fouled.
Lou Rowe that time reacted very badly. He popped way out on the screen when he didn't need to. UMass has done a good job covering the outside screen. Number 32 is going to set the screen. Look how far Rowe goes outside. Moore does a nice job cutting to the basket. The screen was not that good. Rowe did not need to react out that far. And as a result, Harper Williams picks up his third personal foul. Not good defense against that screen and roll.
Eric Moore at the free throw line, a sophomore from Media, Pennsylvania. He and Jerome Allen were high school teammates at Episcopal Academy. And his father, Bruce, is a high school coach at Strathaven High School in Pennsylvania. Like his dad also played at Penn. He's a 65 Penn grad. Penn playing very confidently so far, and the Quakers lead 29-24.
They started the first half very quickly, Mel, and they're starting the second half very quickly.
Dana Dingle has replaced Harper Williams for UMass.
And without Harper Williams, that really hurts the UMass inside game.
It's a blocking foul against Penn, and Barry Pierce, his first foul.
Pierce picks it up against Barbee, number 22 for UMass, penetrating to the basket. Barbee was only two of 10 shooting in the first half.
18-19 remaining in the second half.
Got a quick look at Tony Barbee.
Kellogg is open, but Maloney took too long to get it to him. Rowe rebounding. Lou Rowe scores for the Minutemen. He has 9, and it's a 3-point lead for Penn. Penn has handled the full court press pretty well today. Allen goes right through it and lays it off to Moore. Jerome Allen has begun to loosen up his game a little bit. He hit a shot, also made a nice pass inside. Speaking of great passes, Maloney gets it into Moore, misses the shot. And Sean Trice is fouled by Lou Rowe.
Maloney does a great job getting rid of the basketball. Look at Barbee come to help. Maloney'd like to shoot the ball, but can't. Moore, number 32, steps right in front of Lou Rowe. Pretty good defense by Rowe, but Sean Trice, we said he had three fouls, continues to battle in there. Number 52, Trice gets fouled by number 15, Lou Rowe.
Sean Trice, a sophomore from Detroit at the free throw line. See Mike Williams in the game for UMass. Trice was recruited to Penn by some of the alumni. They've got a strong alumni network in the Detroit area, and they also brought in a football player a couple of years ago, fine running back named Brian Keyes, also from the Detroit area. 30-26 Penn, 17-40 remaining second half.
Very active zone defense by Penn.
Barbie for three. Rebounded by Trice.
Barbie, we mentioned, only 2 of 10 in the first half. Jerome Malloy, the main outside threat for UMass, doesn't have a basket today.
Maloney with that quick release. Didn't waste much time getting that shot off.
Penn's done a great job getting back on defense. They've been able to set their defense most occasions.
Barbie.
Tough shot.
Barbie stays with it. And Tony Barbie scores to cut Penn's lead to 2, 30 to 28. Barbie now has 6 points. And that's an offensive foul on Barry Pierce.
Had Pierce just been able to avoid the temptation to throw his arm out, he would have been fouled by Barbie because Barbie did not have good position.
Harper Williams is back in for the Minutemen.
Watch Barbie lean in right there, but when that arm goes thrown out, that's an automatic call. Had he just proceeded into Barbie, he'd have picked up the foul against Barbie. That's hard to do, though. Try to protect yourself.
Barbie comes out of the game. Harper Williams back in. He misses the shot. And we have a jump ball. The arrow pointing to UMass.
Harper Williams, you saw a little bit ago, only 4 points, 3 personal fouls.
16-24 remaining. Second half action from Syracuse. Penn has led for most of the game. They've led by as many as 8. Right now, nursing a 2-point lead. Rowe rebounding the miss. Harper Williams. Got it. And UMass much more active on the offensive glass this second half.
That's what we talked about before the game, the inside power, particularly Lou Rowe on the offensive board.
The teams are tied at 30. Trey's shot is blocked. Great block by Lou Rowe.
You can just see the energy level picking up by the University of Massachusetts. Rowe just slaps that one away. We'll be back.
I want to find out. I want to find a way out.
Gillette Sensor, the closest, safest, the best shave a man can get.
Gillette, the best a man can get.
Introducing Wendy's Monterey Ranch Chicken Sandwich.
That looks good. May I have a bite?
Is that the new chicken sandwich from Wendy's?
Made with a whole breast fillet.
This looks great.
Monterey Jack cheese.
That's right.
And ranch dressing with bacon, but do yourself a favor.
Buy two.
Life. Around every corner, financial questions, choices, surprises. When you need direction, the Principal Financial Group can guide you toward your goals. With flexible insurance, solid investment strategies, stability you can count on. No wonder people have been coming to the Principal for over a century to secure your future, to get an advantage. Get the Principal Edge, the Principal Financial Group.
If you depend on your truck to last, here's news you should never forget. Of all the Chevy trucks built in the last 10 years, over 98% are still going strong. That's more than Ford, more than Toyota, more than Nissan. Over the years, no other truck is that dependable, foreign or domestic. Only Chevrolet, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
In the city. There are crimes of passion. Will four cops make a difference?
I think he sent us.
You bet they will. Bodies of Evidence, April 2nd.
Penn and UMass tied 30-all with 15:57 remaining in the second half. UMass still not shooting well, but doing a better job getting to the offensive boards.
Penn with the ball. UMass in a man-to-man. They try to go backdoor to Allen, who saved it.
UMass continues to do a good job keeping the ball out of the hands of Allen.
Jerome Allen, the co-player of the year in the Ivy League, sharing honors with Columbia's Buck Jenkins, but he had only 1 point at halftime. Guarded by Mike Williams. To his credit, he really hasn't forced things and taken a lot of bad shots. Puts up a three-pointer he had to with the shot clock winding down.
That was excellent defense by the University of Massachusetts.
Rowe from the outside. He bricks it up, and a strong rebound by Allen.
Rowe's not really a 15-foot jump shooter.
Good passing by the Quakers. Barry Pierce misses the shot. Harper Williams takes it down, and UMass with a chance to take the lead. Mike Williams for three.
He is a three-point jump shooter. Very, very streaky. You can see the excitement on the UMass bench.
It has been a struggle for them today. They trailed for most of the game, plagued by poor shooting. 33-30, UMass. They turn up the pressure defensively. Moore, the center, helps bring it across.
Well, that's a great job by Harper Williams to step out there. Kellogg was lost. Williams stepped out, and so they get a turnover.
And UMass forces a turnover. At the conclusion of every NCAA tournament game, we'll select the Chevrolet players of the game. In conjunction with the award, Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to the General Scholarship Fund of both schools. And UMass gets two more. Harper Williams scoring to make it 35-30, a 9-0 run by the Minutemen.
Great trap.
They've turned up the heat on defense. Allen spots Pierce underneath. Barry Pierce has been the leading scorer today with 13 points, makes it 35-32, UMass.
That's a great trap and a great reaction to get out of the trap and score.
UMass seems to be playing with a lot more confidence. They look tight and tentative in the first half. This run has really gotten them back into the game.
They've gotten the ball inside to their big guys. They're working the offensive boards, and they finally got a three-pointer to go in the basket.
They're in a flow now. They're moving the ball. They're getting better shots. They're rebounding well. Their defense has turned up the heat.
That's the shot clock on the left-hand side of your screen.
Took a while for the real UMass team to step forward today, but it looks like they're playing pretty well right now. Now they've got to look for a shot in a hurry. Williams tries to force it inside, deflected to Dingle, who scores, beating the shot clock.
That's what you call working the shot clock, Mel.
Dana Dingle with 3 points, and Penn looks real shaky right now as they commit another turnover. This press is bothering the Quakers.
It did not bother Fran Dunphy's squad in the first half, but the last couple of possessions, they've struggled against it.
Tony Barbee is back in for UMass, and Jerome Maloney also returns for the Minutemen.
Kellogg is going out of the basketball game, and number 14, Derek Kellogg, has done a great job defensively against Matt Maloney. You know, Mel, Penn has played most of this game in front. Now we're going to have to see how they're going to play from behind.
UMass has outscored Penn 11-2 over the last 4 minutes.
Offensive rebounding has been the key in this half.
Williams with the open shot. Got it. Three-pointer. He's hit two of them.
Two in a row now for Williams.
Well, Mike Williams has given UMass an 8-point lead, 40-32.
John Calipari's squad has been trying to punch the ball inside all game. And I'm telling you what, if those threes are going to start to go in, that's going to make life a little easy on the little easier on the interior.
12:40 remaining in the game. Thank Jerome you. Allen on the drive. Great block by Lou Rowe with authority.
And he tells him to get that stuff out of here.
Take that Ivy League stuff out of here, son.
Penn really needs a basket on this possession.
Knocked the Ivy right off that shot. Dangerous pass. Maloney trying to set the Quakers their offense. UMass has done a good job containing him in the second half. Trice wheels inside, and another block, this time by Williams. Jerome Allen misses. Harper Williams comes down with a rebound. Both Williams and Rowe are very aggressive on the boards now, and Sean Trice has picked up the foul.
That's foul number 4 against Sean Trice. Lou Rowe, Harper Williams have been working hard the entire game. That hard work is starting to pay off. There's the jump shot there. Williams tips the ball once. He's got two guys all over him. Trice makes the mistake of fouling him on the way up the court. Sean Trice, number 52, going to sit down. But Harper Williams and Lou Rowe just all over it inside. And Penn has to be careful. They're on the verge of getting blown out of this basketball game.
Jim Krug and Andy Barada in the game for Penn, replacing Moore and Trice. UMass leads by 8, 12 minutes remaining. Penn in a man-to-man. Mike Williams, who's hit 2 3-point shots, pressured by Maloney, who picks up a foul.
Mike Williams, sort of a dead ringer for Denzel Washington there.
The foul is called, not on Maloney, but on Tim Krug. We'll be back.
Choosing your first new car sure can be complicated. There are cars that promise you safety. Cars that are well-built and well-backed. Cars that won't leave you stranded. Cars that give you a break on the price. Even cars that help with your down payment. But Chevrolet makes it easy to get all of the above in the Chevy Cavalier, the lowest priced car in America with standard anti-lock brakes. Test drive Chevy Cavalier today at your neighborhood Chevrolet dealer.
You know those credit card commercials where they tell you to jaunt off to some exotic paradise? This isn't one of them, okay? We're taking our MasterCard to the supermarket. How's that for exotic? Actually, I guess it is kind of exotic. I mean, you've got a MasterCard. They've got tropical fruit and crystal clear water, right? And now, no card is more accepted on the planet, including supermarkets. And it's smart to use your monthly statement to keep track of your grocery spending. I mean, the supermarket isn't exactly paradise, but at least you can drink the water. MasterCard. It's more than a credit card. It's smart money.
State Farm presents the rules of the game.
Today we're talking about shots taken from three-point range. In this play, the shooter is fouled while scoring a three-point goal. How many free throws are awarded?
Mark and Rennie and little Lindsay are a young family just starting out. They don't have a lot of money for life insurance. I'm their State Farm agent, Gaylord Moosman. Instead of giving Mark and Rennie a big life insurance sales talk, I did a lot of listening. And we came up with a plan that's going to work for their budget and little Lindsay's future, too. State Farm agents are good listeners because we want you to have life insurance you can live with.
State Farm sells life insurance.
When a player is fouled in the act of scoring, he is awarded one free throw. This rule applies whether he scores a three-point goal or a two-point goal.
Rules of the Game has been sponsored by State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
A neighborhood like no other.
I'm gonna get you.
A night known for drama.
Officer down! We've got a hostage situation here.
April 1st, picket fences moves to Thursday.
UMass trailed Penn by 2 at the half. Lou Rowe and Harper Williams have gotten on the boards. Rowe has blocked a couple of shots to inspire his team. Mike Williams has hit 2 3-pointers, and like that, UMass has jumped out to an 8-point lead.
Mel, UMass had 20 points at halftime, and they've already got 20 points in this half.
They're shooting much better in the second half, 56%, hitting 9 of 16 shots, and shot only 26% from the floor in the first half.
Penn gets out of the zone and goes back to the man-to-man. University of Massachusetts on the kick ball. It's going to have another 45.
With 11:38 remaining in the second half, UMass seeded third in the East, leading Penn 40-32, but it's been a struggle for the Minutemen. They trailed by 2 at halftime. We're down by as many as 8 to Penn in the first half, but their play has been much improved after intermission.
The inside strength really told early in this second half. Offensive rebounding a key. There's the inside game again.
Rowe gets the roll. He has 11 points. Rowe and Harper Williams leading the way for the Minutemen, who now lead by 10, their biggest lead. Maloney tries to get 3 back, but his shot is short. Rebounded by Tim Krug.
Allen really needs to get himself open for some hoops.
Can't get any shots off.
Barbie coming off the screen, doing a nice job.
Maloney has gone cold in the second half, and a strong rebound by Harper Williams. Hands above the rim. He has 8 rebounds.
He does a great job with audio on those rebounds as well.
UMass got the wake-up call about 2 minutes into the second half. And they've played well since.
They got four offensive rebounds very early in the second half, and that really keyed their run, and Mike Williams capped it off with a couple of three-pointers.
Williams moves outside, and the rebound to Maloney. Maloney, nice change of pace move, and the dish to Pierce for the jam. Barry Pierce, the leading scorer with 15 points, and it's 42-34 UMass.
Nice job by Penn to get an easy basket. That's part of the Pennsylvania problem in this half. They've been outscored 16-4 because they haven't gotten any easy opportunities. Everything contested. So Fran Dunphy very happy to see that fast break opportunity.
Penn back in a 2-3 zone. 9:50 remaining in the game. UMass leads by 8. Mike Williams passes up the 3 to Dingle. Williams puts up the 3 and can't get it. Rowe rebounding, and he got pushed. Rowe and Williams have been all over the boards.
Lots of times if you're having trouble shooting the basketball, it's because you have contested opportunities. Now, as Harper Williams takes a bad shot for him, look at Penn get out on the fast break. Maloney in the middle, Williams a little slow getting back. Maloney beats the guy outside, gets it to Pierce. That's an easy opportunity. Penn needs more of those.
The foul is called on Tim Krug. That's his fourth. See Derek Kellogg, who's back in the game for UMass. Eric Moore is also back in for Penn. 9:40 left in the game.
That's a nice job by Lou Rowe, trapped on the side, bounces it off a Quaker out of bounds. Lou Rowe's been a big part of this second half surge. He's got 5 offensive rebounds.
Barbie. Nope, he's had a poor shooting day. Moore grabs it. Pierce throws it cross court to Allen. And Jerome Allen slips inside to score.
John Calipari not very happy with that. 2 transition buckets in a row for Penn.
Jerome Allen has been held to 5 points, but he's cut the lead to 6, 42-36 UMass. Kellogg backs it out with 9 minutes left in the game.
Harper Williams out of the game, taking a rest. Penn zone very aggressive.
Dana Dingle drives inside. His shot hit the bottom of the backboard. An opportunity for Penn to cut into that lead a little more. Maloney, 3 points. He has only 3 points in the second half. Moore saves it. Eric Moore. Allen inside to Moore. Got it. And here comes Penn.
And UMass is asking for a timeout. Tremendous effort by Pennsylvania.
Just when it looked like Mass was going to run away with it, Penn has come back to within 4.
The NCAA Women's Final Four, April 3rd on CBS.
You know, our competitor is twice as likely to have a network outage. If you're trusting your important 800 calls to them, well, one of the 800 reasons to choose AT&T 800 service, the best in the business. Hocus pocus. It seems everyone is offering financial advice. We put our faith in research, analysis, and experience. Prudential Securities. The most important thing we earn is your trust.
He scored only 1 goal his first season, but he went on to become the most valuable player in hockey.
Starter.
He was told he'd never start again. He came back to become the best reliever in baseball.
Starter.
Each had a dream, and when you start with a dream, where you end up is up to you.
More and more Americans are discovering that if they spend half of what some other top brands cost, they can buy a Murray, the best quality mower for the money. It's backed by a 2-year warranty and over 8,000 service dealers. That's made Murray one of the top sellers in America. And for the price, one tough, dependable mower. From walk-behinds to riders, even a complete line of mulchers, Murray is always tough as they come.
Thank you.
Why drive an imitation when you can drive the vehicle that originated the species? Chevy Blazer.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
Much improved shooting by UMass, 50% in the second half compared to 26% in the first half. And for Penn, Barry Pierce's play to find game, 15 points, 4 rebounds. But with 8:20 left, UMass leads 42-38.
Penn coming out very aggressively out of the zone defense, trying to create a turnover.
Penn has scored 6 unanswered points to cut the lead to 4. Williams with a great pass into Barbie for the jam. A little touch pass by Harper Williams. And that makes it 44-38, UMass.
When you try to trap on the perimeter, you run the risk of an easy basket. And when you pass the ball that well, the easy basket is almost a foregone conclusion. Nice job by UMass.
Jerome Allen trying to get something off. Nice pass to the open man, Barada, who misses it.
You'd rather have Pierce or Allen or Maloney taking those 15, 20-foot jump shots.
7.5 remaining in the game. UMass leads by 6. Harper Williams, nice pass into Barbie. Blocked by Eric Moore, who's made some big plays in this game. Maloney pushes it up. Beautiful dish to Pierce.
Great play by Harper Williams. Wow, he hustled down the court, bothered that shot.
Barbie backs it out with 7 minutes left in the game. A 6-point lead for UMass.
The expression on Harper Williams' face is just unbelievable. He wants the basketball inside.
Williams moving without the ball, trying to get himself open. Looks a little frustrated that they're not getting it to him.
I throw it to him.
They get it into him with good position inside, and with the left hand, he can't put it down, but he's looking at work on the boards. Penn comes away with a loose ball with 6.5 remaining. UMass by 6. Maloney's pass picked off by Tony Barbie.
Grant Dunphy telling his players just to calm down. That was not a good pass by Maloney. Harper Williams has taken over the game on the inside.
Just over 6 minutes remaining in the game. Barbie from Kellogg. No, but a foul on Eric Moore. They try to work the alley-oop. That's 4 fouls on Moore.
Very nicely designed play by the University of Massachusetts. Barbie starts up at the top with a screen and then rolls to the basket. There's another screen in there by Mike Williams. And Barbie, while he doesn't get the basket, draws the foul from Moore. Nice play.
And Tony Barbie will shoot 2 free throws, a 75% shooter. He has 8 points. Moore comes out after picking up his 4th foul. Barbie, a second team All-Atlantic 10 selection this year. Penn with big foul problems. Krug, Trice, and Moore with 4 apiece.
And that's those are their inside players, Mel. Massachusetts attack inside really paying off, not only in terms of point production, but in terms of foul problems as well.
Jerome Molloy replaces Tony Barbie for UMass. The Minutemen lead 46-38 with 6 minutes remaining. Jerome Allen working hard, but just can't get his shots off today.
That's a great job by Lou Rowe to step out on the screen.
Allen puts up a 3 and buries it.
And Mike Williams just looks at him like, are you kidding me? That was a long 3-point shot.
Got to take what the defense gives you. Trice with a deflection. Allen is open. And Jerome Allen has suddenly come to life. They cut UMass lead to 3, 46-43. Allen now has 10 points.
You've got to respect the firepower of a team like Penn that can shoot the ball so well from the 3-point range. Lazy pass by Massachusetts created another transition opportunity.
5:20 left in the game. UMass leads by 3.
You know, Harper Williams is out of the game again, and it seems every time he goes out of the game, UMass struggles.
Williams for 3. It's short. And Mike Williams may have committed the foul.
You can never relax. There's just a bad pass, a lazy pass by Kellogg, and then the aggressive pass in transition. We talked about the physical skills of Allen on display right there as he ducks under and scores.
The foul is called on Barry Pierce of Penn, and Harper Williams returns to the UMass lineup.
When Williams, Harper Williams, is in the basketball game now, as we look at the turnover statistics, he presents some real problems inside for Pennsylvania. They have to respect the inside game. When he's not in the game, they're much more aggressive on the perimeter, and they have been able to create some turnovers.
Mike Williams, a 71% free throw shooter at the line. 47-43 UMass. Williams with 8 points for a couple of three-pointers.
John Carroll Calipari squad with only two fouls against them in this half. So they're in good shape in terms of the fouls.
48-43 UMass. 5 minutes remaining in the game. Jerome Allen with some fancy ball handling. Beautiful pass inside, but Verratti's shot is blocked. Allen deflected it. Jerome Allen has really come alive here in the last 5 minutes. Allen fakes the three, works inside, dishes to Maloney. He hasn't been able to hit his outside shot in the second half.
He took a dribble and stepped to the basket, Mel. Maybe he was a little out of his range, but he allowed the defense to come and cover him up.
UMass by five, 4.5 remaining.
It's almost as if Jerome Allen from Penn has decided he's had enough of this and he's going to take the ball game over.
Williams calling for the ball inside. He and Sean Trice are pushing each other. Oof. Pressure by Maloney on Kellogg.
10 seconds on the shot clock.
Barbie will go one-on-one. Dishes to Williams. Three on the shot clock. Three-pointer by Mike Williams, his third of the game. He breaks out a big smile every time he hits one of those.
And Fran Dunphy was on his knees, rocked back, nearly fell down. That was a big, big shot.
8-point lead for UMass. Trice to Barada, who hits the open jumper. Andy Barada's basket cuts the UMass lead to 6 with 3:40 remaining.
Fran Dunphy looking for his Quakers to get a defensive stop. UMass doing a great job running the clock down and then getting the three as the shot clock expired the last time down the court. Mike Williams with three big threes in the second half.
Ball stripped away by Trice. It'll be UMass ball with 17 seconds left on the shot clock, and we'll be back.
Available anti-lock brakes on the new Geo Prism can help you negotiate driving hazards during hard braking. And every new Prism comes with a driver's side airbag, which we'd also be happy to demonstrate. But you've seen all that before. Besides, why ruin such a beautiful car? Get to know the newest Geo, Geo Prism, at your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
Who was that masked man who stopped the horses?
I don't know, but he gave me this.
Still going. Nothing outlasts the Energizer battery. It keeps going and going and...
These days, people who want to save money on lunch are brown bagging it. Because McDonald's original hamburger is still just 59 cents. Our delicious cheeseburger is 69 cents. And that is no baloney.
Dean Witter believes every investor's success story is unique. From getting in on the ground floor to getting all the way to the top, Dean Witter can help you make it every step of the way.
We measure success one investor at a time.
A noble warrior advised, the art of protection springs from within. One must stay vigilant against one's unfragrant perspiration, lest one provoke a hostile response. Thus, a Norse ritual is Right Guard Sport Stick. An aromatic array of the freshest scents and maximum protection against disarming wetness.
Confirming the wisdom, the best defense is not to offend.
Right Guard Sport Stick. Anything less would be uncivilized.
A hospital is shut down and a doctor's dream destroyed.
I have to buy that clinic.
I can't give a loan to a single woman.
Dr. Quinn had a special time Saturday.
First round action continues on CBS. Coming up in the Southeast region, Northeast Louisiana faces Iowa. Here in Syracuse will be Manhattan against Virginia. In the Northeast region, Delaware and Louisville, and Yinka Dare, GW's outstanding big men, will lead George Washington into action against New Mexico in the West region. With 3:05 remaining in the game, UMass leading Penn 51-45. This has been a terrific game. Penn led for most of the first half, led by as many as eight, was up by two at the half. UMass came back behind the play of their two big men, Lou Rowe and Harper Williams, and the Minutemen, seated third in the East, have a six-point lead with 2:47 left.
University of Massachusetts has done a great defensive job against the Penn perimeter players, particularly the backcourt, most of the ball game. And when their big guys kicked it in on the offensive boards in the second half, Massachusetts really took off.
UMass doing a good job of using the clock in the second half. The shot clock is under 10 seconds again, but they've had no problem getting off shots in these situations.
Now they're in trouble now.
Mike Williams cast one up. That just grazed the rim. Has to hit the rim for the for not to be a 45-second violation. It'll be UMass ball out of bounds.
And the University of Pennsylvania is asking for a 45-second clock violation, claiming that the ball did not hit the rim.
It did. Just grazed.
But that it hit the rim after the buzzer sounded. They're claiming that the buzzer sounded before the ball hit the rim.
Well, they lose
really
the argument.
That's a break for UMass right there. That was a terrible shot that they were able to get, but they get it back with another 45.
But Penn forces a turnover. Sean Trice up with a loose ball. 2:09 left in the game. UMass leads by six. Matt Maloney has hit only one of his last nine shots for Penn. He's a good three-point shooter, but he's gone cold in the second half.
That's a great job by Williams to cover up that three-point shot.
Trice with a turnaround. Got it, a possible three-point play. Sean Trice powering it in.
This has been a very tough defensive battle that's reflected in the shooting statistics. That's much better than in the first half. That's the second half shooting statistics. University of Massachusetts with three second half three-pointers by Mike Williams. You can see there he's had 11 points in the second half. He's been a big factor. That's Sean Trice at the line. Not only did he score, but he also drew the fourth foul from Harper Williams of the University of Massachusetts.
Three-point play for Trice. And it's 51-48, UMass with a minute 49 remaining. Every possession critical at this point.
UMass comes in here as the number three seed. Penn as the number 14 seed. And in every NCAA tournament since 1985, a number 14 seed has upset a number three seed.
Good pressure by Penn. Twenty-two seconds left on the shot clock, a minute 24 left in the game. UMass leads by three. Barbie picks up his dribble.
Now UMass has to think about getting a shot.
10 on the shot clock. They're not even close to a shot. 7 on the clock. It's down to 5. It's down to 3. Mike Williams for 3. Not this time.
And that's an air ball, so that is a 45-second violation.
So Penn will have the ball trailing by 3 with a minute 3 remaining. And we'll get a timeout with UMass on top, 51-48.
Out here, we work part-time and play full-time.
I was 18, didn't have a care. Working for peanuts, not a dime to spare.
To get the most fun out of every dollar, get into Chevy S10 pickup for around $8,000. From Chevrolet, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
Like a rock. Oh, like a rock.
With Miller Sharps, you get all the crisp, refreshing taste of a great beer without all the alcohol. So take a time out for the great beer taste of Sharps. Anytime.
I feel Dentalex tingling on this side.
nothing on the head and shoulder side. I love that tingle, so I tried Danorex for my dandruff. It really came through. The flaking stopped. My scalp doesn't itch.
Danorex with conditioner is the serious dandruff shampoo.
I've switched to Danorex.
Baby Ruth, Baby Ruth.
My baby isn't beautiful. It looks a lot divine. But if it didn't look so funky,
well, it wouldn't taste so fine.
Baby Ruth.
If it didn't look so funky,
it wouldn't taste so fine.
Yo!
Baby! Come on, look at peanuts.
Well, it's all the stuff I crave.
They make it lumpy, make it bumpy.
Oh, but they make it my babe.
Baby Ruth.
If it didn't look so funky,
it wouldn't taste so fine.
Baby Ruth, Baby Ruth.
Yo! It's a brand new from KFC. The taste will make ya jump, jump.
Introducing new KFC Spicy Chicken Bites. Oven roasted, skinless, tender, and juicy.
New
delicious.
Spicy chicken bites will make ya jump, jump. They make your mouth sing. It's a brand new chickeny, chickeny, chickeny.
Only $1.99 a serving.
Check them out.
Now it's your KFC.
Spicy chicken bites.
For a limited time only.
Jump, jump. Reach to chicken bites.
A party of uncommon elegance requires a chef with the ultimate good taste.
How to chop you up and throw you in the bouillabaisse.
An all-new Northern Exposure Monday.
The University of Massachusetts leads Penn by 3 with 1:03 remaining in the game.
Pennsylvania's got the basketball. You can see the timeout situation. The possession arrow with Penn, a key stat right there. UMass with only 3 personal fouls, so they can afford to be very, very aggressive on defense, particularly on the perimeter and non-shooting situations.
Less than a minute remaining, a 3-pointer would tie it up. Matt Maloney trying to regain his stroke. He had 8 points at halftime, only 3 since, and he unloads. Way short, rebounded by Lou Rowe, and he's fouled.
Foul done.
Foul is called on Barry Pierce of Penn with 45.7 seconds left. That's a 4th foul on Pierce. If this game should go to overtime, Penn is in much worse trouble. Eric Moore, Tim Krug, and now Barry Pierce each have 4 fouls.
That last defensive series for Massachusetts was indicative of what they've been able to do most of the game, and that is do an excellent job defending against the 3-point shots by Allen and by Maloney.
Lou Rowe at the line and misses the first, the front end of a 1-1. UMass has made only 9 of 16 free throw attempts today. And again, an opportunity for Penn.
Going to try to get a screen out at the top for Allen or for Maloney. They need the 3.
Maloney tightly guarded by Barbee.
This is
Allen,
a great job
by Williams. He gets the 3 off and just missed it. And the rebound to Harper Williams with 18 seconds left. And Penn has to foul. Sean Trice commits the foul. That's his 4th as Fran Dunphy paces the sidelines.
He may have seen his team's last best opportunity evaporate, although it's still the 1-1. Fran Dunphy with his 14th seeded Quakers really giving a scare to the 3rd seeded Minutemen of Massachusetts.
And UMass will take a timeout with 14.7 seconds left. So UMass seated 3rd on top of 14 seeded Penn, 51-48.
A little confusion about whose timeout it is. That's what the discussion is about. Who called the timeout?
Tim Krug checks back in for Penn.
Now there is a Pennsylvania timeout.
So we'll return to Syracuse in a moment. UMass up by 3.
Everybody hates to eat and run. We'd rather take it slow. But the way this life is going, gotta grab your food and go. And when all that running round catches up with you at last, get yourself some Alka-Seltzer and you'll feel better fast.
For acid indigestion or heartburn with headache, nothing's faster or more effective than Alka-Seltzer.
Get yourself some Alka-Seltzer and you'll feel better fast.
Use only as directed.
When David and Lisa Edmondson needed life insurance, they came to see me. I'm Kent Spearman, their State Farm agent. I helped the Edmondsons put together a life insurance plan that works for them and their budget. And I stay in touch as their needs grow and change because that plan has to work for their children, Rachel and Travis, too. If you want life insurance that works for you, get an agent who works for you. Get yourself a State Farm agent.
State Farm sells life insurance.
Susie Hamilton, U.S. middle distance runner.
What was good enough yesterday just isn't good enough today. You can't hang on to old victories. That's what performance is all about. That's why I like this stuff so much. It's not the old way of doing things. Shampoo and conditioner in one, Pert Plus. It gives me the results I'm after. Soft, manageable hair without a lot of fuss. Who needs the old way of getting there?
Pert Plus, also in dandruff control.
For many, the search for the world's greatest tuna sandwich ends when they discover Subway's tuna sub right here at Subway. One taste of the combination of our famous fresh baked bread, chunk light tuna, and any or all of our famous fresh fixed fixins, and it'll hit you too. This sandwich is worthy of the title World's Greatest. And now it's an even bigger deal with a special $1.89 price. So come get hooked on the sandwich that's a tuna fish wish come true.
The 6-inch tuna sub, $1.89 for a limited time at Subway.
Can a marriage counselor and a divorce lawyer share an office and still respect each other?
People have fun when they're married.
And then when they get caught, they wind up single again.
Good advice, Friday, April 2nd.
UMass leading Penn by 3 with 14.7 seconds left. Mike Williams will be at the free throw line shooting a 1-1 for UMass. He is a 71% free throw shooter. The UMass has struggled at the line today, making his 9 of 16. Williams has hit 3 of 4. And that gives UMass a little breathing room coming up. Northeast Louisiana and Iowa here at Syracuse. Manhattan faces Virginia. Delaware against Louisville and GW against New Mexico. Penn is down by 4 with not much time left. Jerome Allen on the point. Got it. And a quick timeout by the Quakers. It's 52-50 UMass. Good play by Allen to push it up, hit the quick shot, and the timeout.
McDonald's doesn't have it. Wendy's doesn't have it. It's Burger King's new flame-broiled meatloaf sandwich.
I love this place.
You big meatloaf fan?
Yeah, sure am.
It's the new flame-broiled meatloaf sandwich.
Good deal?
I'm impressed. A flame-broiled meatloaf patty with onions and ketchup. Would you like to try this?
Good. It's much better than my mother ever made.
Oh. Sorry, Mom. How's it taste?
It's very delicious.
It's the new flame-broiled meatloaf sandwich. It's your way right away.
I love this place.
This is hydroplaning in less than an inch of water, and they're not being pulled by a boat, but by Goodyear AquaTread radials. AquaTread's deep groove design channels water away to keep more tire in contact with the road for outstanding wet traction. This is hydroplaning. This is AquaTreading. The all-season AquaTread only from Goodyear. It comes with a 60,000-mile tread life warranty. Goodyear AquaTread. Try a set. We like to say the best tires in the world have Goodyear written all over them.
Nipper and Chipper show us what the RCA home theater with SRS sound looks like. Now they show us what it feels like. Looks like, feels like. Looks like, feels like. Any questions? Now get up to $100 back on selected RCA home theater televisions.
5 hours in a balloon. How romantic.
5 hours? What about my diarrhea?
Don't worry, honey. I brought the Firmatine.
Still going. Nothing outlasts the Energizer. They keep going and going.
Dear Thompson's, I used Thompson's Water Seal Waterproofer on my Redwood furniture. My brother-in-law Lewis used another brand on his Redwood gates. After intense rain, my furniture was like new. His gates swelled shut. Thompson's has no match. Sincerely, Lowell Salzer.
In the city,
help me, please.
There are crimes of passion. Will four cops make a difference?
I think he sent us.
You bet they will. Bodies of Evidence, April 2nd.
UMass leading by 2 with 7.8 seconds left in this first round game from Syracuse.
Got to get the ball inbounds.
And the next foul by Penn will be the 10th foul. This will give UMass 2 free throws, and Harper Williams is hooked by Tim Krug.
Now that's going to be a two-shot foul, but if the guys John Calipari has out on the basketball court, Fran Dunphy wanted to foul Harper Williams. He's a 65% free throw shooter. And even though, there you get a look of the guys on the court, Williams, Harper Williams is the obvious guy to choose. Even if he makes, he's got two shots. And to end this game, he's got to make both of the free throws, because if he only makes one of the two, that makes it a three-point game. There's still almost 7 seconds left. Penn, with the great three-point shooters, has the opportunity to get the ball up the court and get off a three-point shot in 6.6 seconds.
John Calipari calling his team to the sidelines. They lead 52-50 with 6.6 seconds left.
Now what John Calipari is doing is he's talking to his players, because Fran Dunphy is taking his time. Krug fouled out of the basketball game. He's got 30 seconds to get a guy in. Fran Dunphy does. He takes the entire time, using that as a substitute for a timeout to make Harper Williams stand there and think about what he's doing.
Eric Moore has replaced Krug. And Williams strokes the first one to give UMass a three-point lead.
Williams can end any excitement that might be right here. You can see UMass with only three fouls. They have a lot of fouls to give.
That should do it.
UMass
by four, 6.6 seconds left. Maloney with the bomb. Rebounded by Tony Barbee, and UMass, which advanced to the Sweet 16 a year ago, will move into second round play, facing the winner of the Virginia-Manhattan game. The final score in today's first game from Syracuse, third-seeded UMass beating Penn 54-50. So the Minutemen move into the second round. They'll face the winner of Virginia-Manhattan later tonight from the Carrier Dome, New Mexico State against Nebraska. Then the Nightcap, second-seeded Cincinnati, will face Coppin State. We'll step away for a commercial break when we return.